We got the missing link. To make these monster movies better, we throw Dwayne The Rock Johnson on them. Rampage is directed by Brad Payton and stars Dwayne Johnson, Malin Ackerman, Jeffrey Dean Morgan, Naomi Harris, and Joe Manganiello, and a whole bunch of giant monsters. David Okoye is a primatologist best friends with an albino gorilla. But when some crazy canisters come from the sky and land in the zoo, George the gorilla starts acting irrational. He starts growing. He starts getting violent. And David Okoye don't know what to do. But for the government, George is the least of their problems, because out of nowhere, we got a wolf that can fly. We got a crocodile that's going crazy. And they keep growing and growing and growing. So what's the solution? We destroy a bunch of shit and we throw Dwayne The Rock Johnson at him. But can The Rock and George take on this wolf and alligator? We'll have to find out. So this is the third time Brad Payton works with The Rock. They work together in Journey to the Mysterious Island. They also work together on San Andreas, and they said, man, we keep on making hits, so let's keep on going. Let's keep on rolling on this money train. And while on paper, this really made no sense, because this is based on a video game where you just either play one of three different monsters and just bash things together. You just destroyed city. There was no purpose to this game. It's fun, but there's no purpose to this game whatsoever. There's no storyline, there's no nothing. You watch this movie and you go, wait a minute, this could have worked a lot better if you went one way or another. We'll dive on that in just a second. So let's talk about the pros of this movie. Of course, we got Dwayne The Rock Johnson, and he brings his charisma to the table and elevates everything he does. No matter how shitty the movie, The Rock makes it watchable. Baywatch included. You're damn right I'm saying Baywatch included. Everybody else in here? Expendable. Except for one, Jeffrey Dean Morgan. For some reason, he had too much cheese in his grilled cheese sandwich, because he keeps cheesing up everything that he's doing in this damn movie. I'm already lactose intolerant, and this dude already giving me too much cheese in my pizza. But at least he's having fun, so let's keep it on that for a while. Naomi Harris, girl on the side. Joe Manganiello, he was in this movie? And don't even get me started on Malin Ackerman as the villain. But that's not what you came to see in this movie. You didn't come to see no Joe Manganiello. You didn't come to see no Malin Ackerman. Came to see The Rock, though. But you really came to see us, these giant monsters wrecking havoc. Pacific Rim wasn't enough for you. You needed something more. You needed something with some more edge. Now, does this have edge? Kinda here and there. Let me put it to you this way. The biggest con that I can say about this movie is the inconsistent tone throughout this damn movie. One minute it tries to get tense and deep in the relationship between George and David Okoye. But then everyone else starts joking around and throwing one-liners here and there like a kid's movie. Then we have a scene that's extremely similar to Predator. And by that I mean it's extremely violent. Cut to The Rock making jokes about his muscles? Then we get deep again with some anti-poaching message. And we got Negan coming in here with a big ass batch of grilled cheese sandwiches? The movie is all over the place. It's so inconsistent. You kind of wish it had one tone and stuck with it. If it wanted to be cheesy, go ahead and be cheesy as hell, like the Fast and the Furious movies. And it works. If you want to be serious, give it a shot. Just go all the way with it. But this movie kind of just tried to play it safe when it came to tone. Try to give a little bit to everybody, but it wasn't enough to feed anybody. But I will say this, that the movie is elevated by the relationship between this George Gorilla and David Okoye. This is the one thing that actually works and feels natural. The one thing that feels natural is The Rock's relationship with a fake gorilla. Not the relationship he has with Naomi Harris, not the relationship he has with his little buddy, not the relationship anybody has with anybody, but The Rock and his fake gorilla. Another thing I have to say about this movie is that it drags. It drags quite a bit to get to the good stuff, to get to the nitty-gritty, because we are suffering from just crappy cardboard cutout characters. The diabolical master plan businesswoman that just wants to destroy everything so she can get more money. The government officials that can pop up and disappear at any location at a moment's notice. The smart and supportive damsel in distress that is the only one that understands our lead. It drags quite a bit and it makes the movie feel a lot longer than it should be. But when we get to our main event, you came to see monsters destroy buildings. Break them down, tear them apart, or you get your money's worth. Now, I know Pacific Rim had this. I know Pacific Rim had a lot of destruction, a lot of monsters, a lot of robots. There's one thing Pacific Rim didn't have, and that's Dwayne Johnson. You're damn right, Dwayne Johnson's in the middle of the fight with all the monsters and he's kicking ass like the best of them. It literally makes no sense, but since it's Dwayne Johnson, you'll believe it. Fuck yeah, it's a lot of fun. It is a lot of fun to watch that stuff. This movie has 90s summer popcorn written all over it. But it is a shame that it has so many things killing it and dragging it down. While The Rock is just trying to elevate it as much as possible and everybody just keeps dragging him down. Brad Pitt included. Well, what can I say about this movie? Either it's too cheesy or too dark, too violent, too friendly. The only one that stays the course and stays consistent is Dwayne Johnson and his CGI mind. Monsters. Everybody else just falls on the wayside. Damn it, I wanted to like this movie because I like everything with Dwayne Johnson, but I have to be real with everybody and I have to be real with myself. I'm gonna have to give Rampage 2 out of 5 stars. That's 2 out of 5. Well, once again, guys, thanks for watching. If you like what you see here, click like at the bottom. Go to our SoundCloud page for our more extensive reviews. This is Ray from LiveWire, and once again, thanks for watching.